Labor Day passes on Martha's Vineyard. This is a time for summer residents to enjoy their last hurrah before they close their homes for the winter. Soon, the island population will plummet to a mere 15,000 residents from a suffocating almost 160,000 in season. Some of the world's most rich and famous have found sanctuary on Martha's Vineyard. Lured to the island's miles of pristine New England coastline, an anonymous way of life. It is one of the last places in the world where celebrity residents have found they can enjoy a little bit of normalcy in strict comparison with their high-profile lives at home. The ferry boats that operate from Woods Hole in Cape Cod to Vineyard Haven on Martha's Vineyard become less and less filled by travelers seeking to visit this beautiful island. That is, except for fishermen. Over the next 5 weeks, Martha's Vineyard will enjoy the second shoulder season of the year. Spring and fall on Martha's Vineyard are considered by area residents as the best time to be on the island, when all the summer vacation residents are gone, leaving the year-rounders to enjoy the island in peace. It is also time for the annual Martha's Vineyard Striped Bass and Bluefish Derby. This annual event draws more than 3,000 anglers, each vying for a 1-in-8 chance to hold a key at the end of the derby, a key to win a brand new center console fishing boat or this year's 4x4 pickup truck. With over $500,000 in cash and prizes up for grabs for the lucky few, all ages, men and women, boys and girls, will scour the island's most famous fertile fishing grounds from boat and from shore in hopes to catch the prize-winning fish. With names like Squibnocket, Lobsterville Beach, The Brickyard, and The Gut, I endeavored to capture one of the nation's, if not the world's, most captivating, alluring, and exciting fishing tournaments. Certainly the oldest, longest running fishing derbies in the United States.
Ready?
Ready.
The annual Martha's Vineyard Striped Bass and Bluefish Derby is about to begin.